Hey there, I'm Ruben and welcome to the interface and features video for De Capo, Sonokinetic's multi-sampled symphonic orchestra. In this video I'll be looking at the De Capo interface in detail and demonstrating how the controls affect the sound and performance. If you haven't yet watched De Capo in action, please take a look at the auditions video to get a taste of the sounds on offer. The full version of De Capo runs as one patch with all orchestral sections and sounds available within one interface. When you load the instrument for the first time, bear in mind that De Capo will apply the position of your mod wheel as soon as the new instance is loaded. So if the sustains sound too soft, just push your mod wheel up. This is the front page of De Capo. From here you have access to strings, brass, woodwind and percussion on these four buttons here. Clicking each button will take you through to another page in the interface where you can choose the instruments and articulations that you need. You can always return to the previous page with the back arrow just here. To choose an instrument section, click into the page, click your instrument first, and then choose an articulation. You'll see the usable keys light up as colours on the keyboard just here. Red keys indicate the range of the currently selected orchestral subsection, in this case mid-brass. And the yellow keys show the rest of the active ranges for the other orchestral subsections. In this case, it's violins 1 and 2. Multiple articulations can be selected. For example, you can stack a sustain with a staccato to give a sharper attack to the played note. Volumes for sustain and legato are controlled by the mod wheel. And velocity controls the volume of the staccato, moccato, and pizzicato patches. So let's have a look now at how legato works. To activate legato, just click the legato articulation button. Sustain samples will also load. Legato can be played in the normal way, just by pressing one key and then holding to the next, then release. De Capo features polyphonic legato, which means that you can play more than one legato line. For example, here we've already got violins 1 and 2 loaded, so let's load the basses and activate legato there on the low range. We can now play those together. Legato transitions are activated up to an octave apart. The key mapping of De Capo works best if your contact instrument is set to plus 2 octaves, which is the default for most people. This means that middle C on the keyboard will be C3, and the section mapping that you find within the interface will correspond with the mapping charts in the documentation. De Capo purges samples that are not being used and loads only the samples that you need, so you may need to wait a few moments whilst the samples load into RAM when you've selected new samples or even microphone positions. Bear in mind that it's quite demanding on your resources to load more microphone positions. For each mic, you would add 8 more voices to your polyphony, so we do recommend mic positions deca and wide to give a nicely balanced sound. For this video, I've got maximum voices in contact set to around 2000, but the default De Capo instrument is set to 500. Depending on the speed of your system, you might want to adjust the max voice level to achieve a smooth playback. Of course, more voices will mean that you can load and play more simultaneous mic positions and articulations. De Capo has 4 microphone positions recorded: a clean, close sound, deca tree, wide microphone position, and microphones placed above the orchestra in the balcony of the hall. These can all be turned on or off just by clicking the buttons, and their levels adjusted with the sliders just here. Bear in mind that your microphone settings are applied globally to the whole instrument and all orchestral sections. However, if you'd like to have an alternative mic position for a section, just load another instance of De Capo and change the mic settings to your taste. If your system is struggling with lots of sections and mic positions, try loading the 16-bit version of De Capo instead. There are also updates planned shortly with light patches that will limit the instrument to one mic position only for even more resource-friendly patches. For more information about this and future updates, make sure to subscribe to our social media pages on Twitter and Facebook and our newsletter at www.sonokinetic.net. Panning for each section or instrument is controlled by adjusting this ring just here. Click and drag. Volume level is adjusted in the same way with this control. On the main page, you've also got global options for panning and volume. You can mute individual sections with the mute button. You can also clear the instrument selections and articulations by clicking the legend here. This will clear all the loaded instruments. If you just want to clear one particular section, you've also got that option too. For example, here with brass, you can clear just by clicking brass. That works the same with woodwind, percussion and strings, and it will unload the section and leave the other sections active. The control on the top left here will adjust the tuning of DiCapo from the standard frequency of A at 440Hz to 442, which is the normal tuning of a live orchestra. Using this option here will help you blend DiCapo with live orchestral recordings much more easily without having to pitch shift everything. There is an impulse response within DiCapo modelled on the hall in which the orchestra was recorded. Click it on and off just here. And you can also adjust the level and the size of the hall. Just click and drag. You can always change the impulse response for the whole instrument by opening the contact editor and browsing down to the Convolution plugin. You can load your own Convolution reverb here, or if you want to save some more resources, you can always replace it with a standard reverb. We chose the Convolution reverb because we recorded it in the same hall as DiCapo. As well as the full version of DiCapo, you'll find individual contact patches for percussion, brass, woodwind, and strings. These patches are exactly the same, just with one particular instrument group. The only difference is the articulations can be selected with key switches here at the bottom of the keyboard. These patches use less RAM and system resources than the full multi-sampled orchestral patch, which doesn't use key switches due to the enormous range of the instrument. For more information about DiCapo, please head to www.sonokinetic.net or check out our other videos. Thanks for listening and have fun with DiCapo.